You killed Vinny, right?
All right. You need a statement.
What is it?
I wanted him dead, and now he's gone. And I'm okay with it.
Angelica was 37 years old, and she was originally from Latvia. She came to the US in 2000. She actually found love here in America with a man named Vince Villafor, 46 years old, and was from Poughkeepsie, New York. It was very much free-spirited. They didn't have kids tying them down. They both didn't have commitments. They were all about having fun and living in the moment. And then only 5 months into their relationship, they got engaged. And on April 19th of 2015, they decided to go kayaking in the Hudson River. By 4:15, they had successfully made it to Bannerman's Island, and then at 7:15, the weather got really bad. And unfortunately, as they were trying to get back, Vince's kayak flipped over, he fell out, and he went into 48 degree water. Freezing, dude. He was not wearing a life jacket or a wetsuit. They were not prepared for this at all. So according to Angelica, Vince called out to her to call 911, and this was the last thing she would hear him say before he slipped off of his kayak and drowned. Angelica then fell into the water too, and rescuers luckily got there in time to save her, but by the time they got there, they couldn't find Vince's kayak or his body. Just straight gone. Shortly after this, she also posted a video of herself doing cartwheels onto her Facebook and also sang karaoke live at an event and looked completely happy. As time went on, actually 10 days later on April 29th, Angelica decided to bring flowers to the area where he was drowned. Interestingly enough, a detective joined her to the island, and he claims that Angelica then confessed to him that she killed Vince. She even said that she pulled the drain plug on his kayak and that she also removed the ring that holds the paddles together. Now, Angelica claims that she did not say this. She said they completely made this up. However, she was arrested that day. She was taken into custody at the Orange County, New York jail and was interrogated for the next 11 hours. Now, if you don't know much about interrogation or crime, there are so many instances of interrogation abuse, manipulating people, using people, not being ethical about the entire interrogation process, and there have been tons of false confessions. Right away in her interrogation, she said that she never told anyone that she purposely killed Vince. That was just straight up not true. She said that the detective made the whole thing up and that she would have done anything to save Vince. Why would she confess to a detective if she was just gonna go in and say she didn't do it? It just doesn't make a lot of sense. Now, one thing about her that you gotta know is that Angelica's just kind of weird. She's just kind of off, and just because people are weird doesn't make them criminals. She told investigators that Vince had added her to his life insurance policy 6 months earlier. That definitely gives us a motive, especially with how fast their marriage moved along. However, the evidence from the actual scene doesn't really make a lot of sense. As the interrogation went on, she started to claim that her relationship with Vince wasn't very good. She said that he was very demanding of her and expected her to perform many behaviors and favors to which she was not comfortable doing. And that is definitely abusive if that's true. After hours and hours and hours of being interrogated, she claims that she just told them what she thought they wanted to hear. When Vince drowned, she felt a sense of freedom and euphoria. However, she continuously said that she did not purposely drown him or do anything to make him drown. The only thing that she said was that when it happened, she decided to just let it happen and couldn't have saved him, obviously. She's definitely not strong enough to save him out of that, but was kind of relieved. Like, if anything, it seemed like she was in an abusive relationship, possibly, and it was more just convenient that he died. So Angelica finally said this.
You killed Vinny, right?
No.
No, I'm asking you the question.
I
want you to tell me the truth.
I am telling you the truth.
What is the answer to that question?
I didn't want him.
Angelica, what is the true answer to that question?
All right, you need a statement.
What is it?
I wanted him dead, and now he's gone, and I'm okay with it.
So, this really leaves investigators with a very interesting situation, but let's look at the evidence from the crime. Since investigators didn't find his body, they started to form a theory that maybe she killed him in a different type of way and just made it seem like he drowned, like just got rid of his body. When investigating, they had found that one of Vince's guns was missing from his house, so they started to think maybe she shot him off the kayak and he fell in and drowned. However, in May, the police were actually securing the Hudson River for a graduation ceremony when they there were reports that there was a body in it. They obviously went and found this body and determined that it was Vince. His body didn't even go that far from where he fell in. It only traveled about a mile south from the original spot. Vince's body had no bullet holes or any other signs of any other type of death other than drowning, and it was confirmed that Vince drowned. However, soon after this, a grand jury officially indicted Angelica for this crime and accused her of second-degree manslaughter and second-degree murder. And the theory was that she purposely removed his drain plug on the kayak, which I'll have to tell you is at the top of the kayak. So it's actually very hard to get it to fill with water. The problem with this theory is that when they tested this, they dumped tons of water, as in wave water, into the side of the boat, which makes sense because there was a storm that day. And the boat fills with water very easily from the simulation of waves. However, when they tried to pour these waves onto the drain plug on the top, barely any water got in the kayak. So basically they have realized now that removing a drain plug cannot sink a kayak. That missing drain plug is certainly not the cause of his death. So in the time that Angelica was waiting for her trial, she spent 2 years in prison. And this trial ended up not even happening. Then they found evidence that Vince knew that the drain plug was open. They found images of his car on the day that they were driving out there, where he had secured his kayak to his car by using a drain plug that was unscrewed. So chances are he knew that it was taken off. There was also other pictures of Vince with his kayak where the drain plug wasn't on it. So it seemed like something he just kind of did. So to me, it seems like there is definitely not enough evidence beyond a reasonable doubt to accuse this person of murder. The media painted her extremely negatively from the beginning. And I've seen straight up lies. I just watched a YouTube video here about this case where it was just straight lying. So I really like to look at these cases unbiased, and to me, I just personally feel like there's not nearly enough evidence that she did this. But basically, she was given the chance to either plead guilty and be out of jail in 6 weeks for good, or go to trial and possibly get life in prison. So she decided to plead guilty, and the plea was different too. It was not agreeing to murdering him or to planning murder. It was agreeing that she could have contributed to it or didn't do enough to help. And now she has a felony on her record, which she decided was better than going to jail, possibly going to jail for the rest of her life. She spent a total of 2 years and 7 months behind bars when she could have been out and she could be completely innocent. But because she pleaded to involuntary homicide, there is still a chance that she could claim half of Vince's life insurance money. And so his parents are fighting back on that. There's lots of debate on whether or not she should get that. The whole thing is super, super odd. Angelica is now free. She's enjoying life out of prison. But I mean, this story is not over, and yeah, it's very, very interesting. And I hope you guys are having a great day, and I will see you next time. Bye.